Hello students, welcome to this presentation on the basics of acceleration analysis in mechanisms part 1. In this part we are discussing about the basics of acceleration as far as the acceleration analysis in mechanisms is concerned. In this slide we are trying to understand the meaning of acceleration. We all know that the acceleration is defined as the rate of change of velocity and denoted by the small letter a, and mathematically given by the ratio delta v by delta t, where delta v is the change in velocity and change in time. Change in velocity is nothing but the difference between the final velocity and the initial velocity of the moving body. Students, we also know that acceleration depends on change in magnitude and direction of the velocity. And if both of these are not changing, then we must say that the body is not accelerating. Means it is moving with uniform velocity. Also, we know that the acceleration is a vector quantity, means it is having both magnitude and direction. To try to understand more about the acceleration of a particle moving about a point. So here is a point P at a distance r from the center of the circle O. At this particular instant, the velocity of the point P is v, and this vector is perpendicular to this OP. Now after time interval dt and traversing angle d theta, the new position occupied is q, and at this point the velocity is v plus dv, means there is increase in velocity by dv, there is change in velocity. Now the same thing can be represented with the help of the vector polygon. This vector OP, which is parallel to this velocity of point P, this vector OQ, the velocity of point Q, v plus dv, and this vector PQ is the change in velocity. Change in velocity. So the point P moves from its position at this point to Q. During this period, there is change in velocity by dv. So this vector PQ is nothing but the change in velocity. Now this can be resolved into two components. So one is along OP and other is perpendicular to OP. Now just extend this vector and also draw a perpendicular from Q till it intersects this vector at point X. Now PX is a component parallel to OP, that is along OP or OX, and other is perpendicular to OP, that is component XQ. In the next slide we will see what are the implications of this. Now you see, the change of velocity PQ has two components, PX and PQ, which are mutually perpendicular to each other. Hence, the rate of change of velocity, nothing but acceleration, will also have two mutually perpendicular components. This concept is very, very important in analysis of acceleration in mechanisms. Now the first component, which is parallel to the velocity of the particle at a given instant, is Px. It is nothing but the tangential component. And the second component, called as centripetal or radial component, is perpendicular to the velocity of the particle at a given instant, that is xq. Now Let us try to know the magnitudes of these two components of accelerations. Firstly, the magnitude of the tangential component of acceleration denoted by AT, T stands for tangential, which is given by alpha times the radius. Alpha is nothing but the angular acceleration of the particle. So this component Px is the tangential component of acceleration given by the angular acceleration times the radius at which the particle is or body is moving, that is r, radius at which the particle is rotating. Now the second component x cube, called as centripetal or the radial component of acceleration, denoted by ar, radial component of acceleration, which is given by omega square into r. We know that omega equal to v by r, so substituting for omega square equal to v square by r square into r gives you v square by r. So again, omega is the angular velocity of the particle and v the velocity of the particle. So the tangential component is in terms of angular acceleration, and the radial component is in terms of angular velocity or linear velocity. Now let us extend this discussion to a kinematic link. So let us say AB is a rigid link and it is rotating about point A with angular velocity omega and angular acceleration alpha. Now at point B, there will be two components of acceleration. One is the tangential component of acceleration ATBA, which is perpendicular to link AB, and second component is the radial component or the centripetal component of acceleration ARBA, which is from B to A along this direction. So B rotates about A, so always the radial component of acceleration is the point under consideration and about which it rotates. About A, B is rotating, hence the direction is from B to A. Now this is represented with the help of the acceleration diagram, or you can say acceleration polygon. Now we will first represent the radial component of acceleration of B with respect to A, denoted by the vector B dash x. Remember, in the acceleration analysis, all the points are denoted with smaller letters and with prime, that is dash, B dash. So the radial component of acceleration of B with respect to A is parallel to link BA. It is from this point to this. So this is the radial component of acceleration. So the magnitude of the radial component of acceleration B dash x is nothing but V square AB by AB, where AB is the link length, AB. V is the velocity of B with respect to A. So the magnitude of the radial component of B with respect to A can be calculated by this. Okay. And also the tangential component of acceleration of B with respect to A, from x you draw the vector, because here the angular acceleration of the link is known. So the magnitude of the tangential component of B with respect to A can be easily calculated by using the relation alpha into AB. AB is again a link length of link AB. So this is the magnitude of the tangential component of acceleration of B with respect to A. So this component A dash B dash is nothing but the total acceleration of B with respect to A. So as I have already told, the radial component is along the link, that is from B towards A, B towards A. Okay, this. So this is parallel to link AB, and tangential component is perpendicular to link AB. So this should be understood clearly. Right. Now the second component, as I mentioned in the previous slide, is the tangential component, of acceleration, which is perpendicular to the link drawn from x to a dash. By using this formula, the magnitude of tangential component is calculated. Hence, the total acceleration of B with respect to A is nothing but the radial component and the tangential component. So this is the total acceleration of B with respect to A. So in the polygon, it is represented by A dash, B dash. One more thing, very very important point to be kept in mind. Now, in case in a problem, if it is stated or given that the link rotates with uniform speed n or uniform angular velocity in terms of radians per second, then the angular acceleration alpha will be 0, because the change in velocity is 0, hence angular acceleration will be 0. So as you know, the tangential component of acceleration is given by alpha times the link length, and if alpha is 0, then the tangential component of the link becomes 0. So whenever a link is having or rotating with uniform RPM or uniform angular velocity, then that link will have 0 tangential acceleration. That means the tangential component of that link will be 0. This will be 0. So then the link will have only this component, the radial component of acceleration. This should be understood very clearly by each one of you. Thank you so much for your attention.